Well, the adventure of my life is pretty fun and huge. I call my life sort of a mosaic because I've done so many different things. When I was 10, obviously I started working on the Waltons and did that until I was 21, almost 22. And was an actress all of those years and found my way through this wonderful, wacky Walton life and was kind of plucked from my own family and plopped down into this Hollywood family and had to learn how to go back and forth between my real life and my Walton life. And it was challenging and wonderful and weird and wild and a kind of a crazy way to grow up. Now, where it takes me to is I am an actress still. I'm an author. My book, Lessons from the Mountain, has just come out. It's very exciting. And the book really chronicles all of it. It chronicles the show before I was on the show, my real family, the difficulties that I had while growing up. The book deals with body image issues that I had and horrible mistakes and diets that I made. And it talks about coming out the other side as well and becoming an activist for women's health issues. My dad always told me to make good lemonade. So with the lemons that I felt I was handed at the time, I've tried to make the best lemonade possible. Some of the ways I've done that is by being a voice for women in Washington, D.C. on women's health issues. I was diagnosed with lupus, so I went to Washington and lobbied Congress for money for lupus research. I was the founding director of Lupus LA. And always trying to give back, I eventually became a coach, and I work with women and men and young women and teens about their body image issues, about self-confidence and self-esteem. And I put on workshops, and I also do public speaking to try and educate. I think the reason I do the workshops for women and I speak out is because I grew up never feeling I had a voice. So when I found my voice, I felt it was important to share my bad choices and negative experiences because it did come out the other side. A lot of former child actors don't come out the other side. So I feel really lucky. And I think the thing I learned the most is that everyone felt the same way I did. I felt completely isolated and alone because, I don't know why, maybe because I was on television. But what I found out is that so many young girls and so many women feel the way that I felt. I've been writing the book for years. I've always been a writer ever since I was a kid. There are some poems that I wrote when I was a kid in there. I think now, being older, I'm going to be 50 in a couple of weeks. So I think now is the perfect time. My life has kind of come to a circle. In these first 50 years, I felt I actually had something to say. And working with people, it really encouraged me to share what I have learned and what I did do, so hopefully no one will make the same mistakes I did. When people read my book, I really want them to have a sense of this wonderful life that I've had. I mean, the fun, wonderful times on the Waltons, the good and the bad, the crazy and the funny and the tough. I'd like to have people have a sense of not feeling alone. And I'd like people to really learn how, you know, they can start to apply how to come out the other side. And I think for me, it's just always been important to share it because I kept it secret for so long and that was so damaging to me. I just got an email this morning from someone who read the book and she said, "Will you please come to my town and do a workshop? I have not found my voice yet. Can your next book be more about how I can actually find my voice?" And that's why I wrote it. I do get a lot of emails from people saying that the book has touched them. It's been surprising because a lot of men have written to me. And I talk about my dad in the book a lot, and his death, and him dying, and just in different things. And I was surprised that a lot of men have been saying, "I completely relate to this. This is so important. I felt exactly the same way." So it's the reason I wrote it. I didn't write it to air a bunch of dirty laundry and throw people under the bus. I throw myself under the bus, but no other Walton family members. And it is rewarding. It's sort of the reason that I wrote the book was really to help people because I feel very lucky to have come out the other side. I can be found at marymcdonough.com. And if anybody wants to talk to me about coming in to do a program or a workshop, they can contact me through marymcdonough.com, my website.